It is our final volleyball weekly update of the year. The head coach alongside Dan Georgalas. And as we talked about last week, congratulations in order for making the postseason for the first time in 15 years. And you go down to Edinburgh, Texas, and you win the opening round match in the NIVC, lose in round two to a very good team, the host in UTRGV. But to go down there to win a match, just overall thoughts on the performance and how the weekend went.
Overall, the experience was really rewarding. I think our team and our group really enjoyed one more weekend together. Our seniors certainly have invested a ton into this program and deserve that postseason opportunity. And the biggest reward will come in the future years as our underclassmen and younger players got to experience a national postseason tournament for the first time. So overall, getting a win was a great performance for us, but we wish we could have got one more.
Certainly some significant steps in the right direction for the second consecutive year. I mentioned 18 victories this year coming off what you did the year before. Just this has been a very solid run trying to get things back in the right direction for this program. So how did you think this year went?
Very happy. There's nothing but compliments from our coaching staff to our players in our locker room right now. You mentioned it. It's the first time our program has qualified for a national postseason tournament in the NIVC. We did beat Louisiana 16-14 in the fifth set, so that was a very emotional match. They were a very, very good team that played very fast and definitely challenged us defensively, but super happy to get that win. That was a first in program history. 18 wins, as you mentioned, this season totals 37 over the last 2 years. It took us a seven-year stretch previously to get to that win total. So something we're super, super happy and grateful for. A couple individual performances on the year certainly stand out. Crystal currently ranks third in the country in total kills. Reagan Riley currently ranks 13th in the country in total assists. And then one thing that we're grateful for, we broke the program attendance for our single match against USD at home this year. So overall, I couldn't be happier with the last 2 years after the pandemic season we started with. And I credit our senior class. We've built a great foundation to build off of moving forward.
Speaking of that senior class, of course, there's five that will no longer be a part of this program in the future. And so there's all those emotions in that it's a fun time to look forward, but also you're losing some significant contributors. And those seniors become the leaders and the heart and soul of your team.
Yeah, the example they've made in the locker room will continue to impact our program moving forward. The younger players know what our culture is about. Our younger players know how to fill their shoes moving forward. And to have this NIVC experience in Texas this last week is really going to help us when we get to those championship moments again in the years to come.
And the years to come, again, we look at what's forward, what's in the future for Jackrabbit Volleyball. And you see some of those pieces. You see it's sort of bubbling here to the surface what can be for Jackrabbit Volleyball.
Yeah, you know, stringing together winning seasons is something that we want to create a standard with. So our younger players have seen this is how we go win non-conference tournaments. This is how we perform in the Summit League. This is how we keep moving up Summit League regular standings year to year. So our group's ability to elevate our expectations has been tremendous because as we move on from season to season, that bar is going to get raised a little bit higher. And our new recruits, when they come in, it'll be a totally different program they're walking into.
All right, so to wrap this up, what's next? What occupies your time here in the weeks and months ahead?
Oh, yeah, it's recruiting. We just got back from Texas yesterday in two different waves. So I think one thing our program didn't have experience with is how to play volleyball this late in the year and still manage our academics. You know, our players have an off day from school and then final start on Thursday. So we definitely were a little stressed out on the road this weekend, but when you take a step back and have different perspective, you know, every team in the NCAA tournament deals with that. That's something our program doesn't have experience with. Moving forward, as we look to make NCAA qualification and deeper Summit League tournament runs and stuff like that, academically, this experience will really pay off for us. Yeah.